Listen, I love FL Studio like the next man, but Ableton, no. Just found out that you Ableton users were being selfish, not telling me the secrets behind Ableton. I was always wondering how people were interpolating samples, always wondering how my friends sounded just like the records that from the 70s, 80s, and the 90s. I just figured it out. I know I'm super late to the game. Please leave your comments and a thumbs up if you're late too, or if you're not late, thumbs up to let me know that I'm a piece of garbage for not knowing this earlier, not sharing this with you, because this here is probably one of the greatest things I've ever seen in any DAW, hands down. This here, when I say this here, this right here, that stuff right there is the reason why Ableton is incredible. Doesn't mean I'm leaving the FL gang for life. You already know what it is. When I show you how to do this, it's gonna transform everything you do in music production, every single thing. This is how producers are taking chords from these top songs, taking chords from like hit records, flipping it into their own thing. I always wonder like, how are they getting the exact vibe without knowing everything? I'm like, he doesn't know much about music theory, how's he? Now, this doesn't mean neglect music theory, because once you do this technique, you're still gonna have to know music theory to extend the idea and to edit stuff and make it make sense. So you still get training from busyworksbeats.com. We got you covered. Music theory essentials. Now let's move into Ableton and I'll show you the trick. This is literally going to blow your mind. If you're not familiar with Ableton's feature here, don't write a comment yet, because it's gonna give it up for all the other people. What I'm gonna do is grab this gospel record. We're gonna drag it in Ableton and listen to the couple chords in the beginning. Okay, so very gospel-y. So what I'm gonna do to save computer time is cut the sample right here. This feature makes me wanna go into the sample series even deeper. It makes me love sampling again. Like, I love sampling again. So again, thumbs up if you're an Ableton fanboy. I guess you call it Ableton Gang. They stole FL Gang's thing. But what do you guys call yourself in Ableton? Do you call yourself Ableton Gang, Ableton Squad? That sounds kinda cheesy. I don't know what you guys call yourself. So you gotta let me know in the comments below. But right click, and here's the magic. Now, not only can you take out the groove, so if it's a drum track, you can take out the groove of the drums so that it's perfect timing with the drums. Or you can right click and convert the harmony to a new MIDI track, which will take the chords out of a record and put them into an instrument. Now, when you see this next step, it's gonna blow your mind. It takes out the chords from a record. I'm gonna mute the original record. Maps out the chords for you, and it picks an instrument that sounds like the instrument used in the record. This is the most insane thing to me, how it knows which instrument you is from the record. So listen. I'm about to cry. I am about to tear up. That is beautiful. That is absolutely incredible. And I wanted to share that with you today because this is gonna open up a completely new realm of music production, period. This is gonna open up so many great things. So friend, I didn't forget about you if you're FL Gang. This is FL Gang for life. You flail me flam, it is FL Gang for life. However, Ableton is amazing, and I wanted to show you that trick. You can do it in FL Studio, by the way. I'm not sure how accurate it will be, and you definitely don't get it picking the instrument for you. Maybe I'll do another video. So if you want the FL video of how to do this, leave a thumbs up and a comment below. That will let me know that you want to see the FL video of this. Blew my mind. Thanks for watching today. Have fun today. It's BusyWorksBeats.com.